kau dalam sini yang lain.
So the 1970s was a training ground for myself. And when I had assistants, I would prepare everything. So I was the writer, I was the director, I was the supervisor, and I also did a lot of the work that normally you have assistants down the line to do it. So, and then 1980s, I was now promoted to be the head of my section. And coincidentally, we had a new information minister, Dato' Sri Ade Badam, and a new director general, Dato' Aziz Wok. So when he came to visit us, Datuk Sri Adib, he was shown the first short animation film ever done in Malaysia that had never been screened. It started in 1961, finally was completed in 1978, but it was shelved for political reasons. So again, we see politics coming into the picture, and what do you call? At the time, it was Datuk Harun Idris corruption case. And Tun Hussein On was the Prime Minister at the time. And in the film, the crocodile has caught hold of the buffalo's leg and wouldn't let go. Then along comes Sang Kanjil, and Sang Kanjil asked what's happening. Then of course, both have both versions of the story. And then Kanjil says, well, the crocodile is hungry and you were stupid, so what to do? Okay, anyway, let's get a third opinion. So there's an old mat floating in the river. And Kanjil asked the mat, and the mat says, well, this is the world the way it is. When we are useful, people make use of us. When we are not useful, they discard us. So it seems that it reflected on the Harun Idris case, where he actually got whatever he got for a certain political party.
So, sekarang bila sudah buruk aku tak berguna lagi, lalu dibuang begini hina. Hai, beginilah dunia penuh kekejaman dan kepalsuan.
On Sunday I'm reading the Sunday Times, and I'm reading that the director general is saying Film Negara is going to make 13 episodes of Sang Kanjil. So I said, is that so? I'm the head of the section, how come I didn't know about this? So I was never asked. But it's a good thing I was not asked. Because if I had been asked, I would say, we can't do it because I myself have never done it. None of my staff have been trained. We are here only to do film titles and sets. So it was good that, you know, it's like throwing you at the deep end. And if you want to survive, you will swim. And so the animation industry started, and the people who were involved in the early stage were all inspired by what we had done in Film Negara. So they said, hey, we can do animation also. And by the end of the 90s, digital technology had just come in, and they tested certain software, and they said that, well, we can do animation, bypass the normal method, and still, you know, make it look like animation.